Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala asrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'du. First of all, let us praise and thank to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us his grace and guardian so that until now we are given infinite health. Secondly, greetings and salawat to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who has given us direction from the dark path to the bright path, namely Islam. Please allow me, Kiaran Gita from SMP Muhammadiyah 1 Gresik. I will deliver the speech under the title How to Prevent and Avoid the Coronavirus. Islam is a religion that is rahmatan lil alamin, alias which provides guidance to achieve safety, happiness, and prosperity. Islam provides teachings and salvation as a world which covers all aspects of life, including matter of health, but physically, mentally, and socially. Health is a form of great grace for mankind as a basic asset in life. Because without health, humans cannot carry out their responsibilities related to the interests of themselves, their families, and communities, as well as their duties and obligation to perform worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we know, the coronavirus first appeared in Wuhan, one of the cities in China. This virus is said to arise from unhealthy food and poultry, which in Islam itself is prohibited or haram for consumption, such as rats, snakes, and bats. Islam has long talked and encouraged people to eat food that are good and halal, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah verse 168. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ya ayyuhan nasu kulu mimma fil ardi halalan thayyiba wa la tattabi'u khutuwati syaitan. It means, hi all people, eat what is clean and good from what is on the earth, and do not follow the step of Satan, because actually Satan is real enemy to you. Taking precaution is the best way to deal with the coronavirus outbreak that caused the COVID-19 pandemic, which has hit more than 200 countries in the world, including Indonesia. How to prevent and avoid the coronavirus can be done by adopting healthy hygiene habits. This prevention is considered the best way to avoid disease because until now, there is no cure or vaccine. Number one, wear a mask. Masks are still one of the most important personal protective equipment used to prevent the spread of corona COVID-19 virus. Although previously it was recommended for sick people, but now people are also encouraged to use it. Number two, wash your hands. Routine hand washing with soap is also a major recommendation by the World Health Organization, or WHO. After handling any object and when you are about to do anything, especially eating and touching sensitive organs such as mouth, nose, and eyes, wash your hands properly and properly in order to reduce the bad germs entering the body. When you are in condition where it's not possible to wash your hands, you can use a hand sanitizer or antiseptics. Number three, cover mouth when sneezing or coughing. Coronavirus prevention can also be done with self-awareness to always cover your mouth when sneezing or coughing. The goal is that any germs that may be present not easily spread to other people. Number four, social distancing. Social distancing is distance from others. Social distancing is recommended at least between you and other people. Why is that? Because when someone coughs or sneezes, they spray small liquid droplets from their nose or mouth, which may contain the virus. If you are too close, you can inhale water droplets, including the COVID-19 virus, if the person is coughing. Ladies and gentlemen, besides that, you have another social distancing rule, namely self-isolation for 14 days. This is important for the prevention of the coronavirus. Number five, avoid physical contact. Try to avoid physical contact with anyone to avoid contracting the coronavirus, either with people who look healthy, people under surveillance or ODP, patients under surveillance or PDP, especially patients who are positive for COVID-19. Number six, avoid crowded places. Crowded places have the potential to become a source of transmissions or transmissions of COVID-19 without being noticed. In a busy or crowded place, it means that the distance between one person in another is very close. Number 7, report yourself. For those of you who have several complaints or symptoms that are similar to COVID-19 and have been going on for a few days, we recommend that you report yourself to the COVID-19 hotline provided by 111 government or contact the nearest health facility hotline from where you live. It is better not to go directly to the hospital or health facility because the potential for transmissions of the second cough SARS virus on the way is still very possible. Number 8, update information. You need to update the latest information about COVID-19 to find out what developments are and what the risk of COVID-19 transmission is. Number nine, and the last, get enough rest and eat nutritiously. Not everyone who is infected with the new coronavirus has died. There are people who have recovered thanks to their immune condition and good health services. To keep the body's immunity in prime condition, we don't want to get enough rest and eat nutritious food. Ladies and gentlemen, in carrying out all of this, let us citizens stay at home more. Work and study also from home to avoid potential transmissions and break the chance of transmissions of this coronavirus. You are still allowed to leave your house if under certain conditions and still follow the recommendation from the Ministry of Health regarding good procedures for entering and leaving the house during this pandemic. Well, may this pandemic end soon. Amen. I stop here my speech. Sorry for my mistakes. The last I say, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.